4 o'clock and I'm weirdly punctual. Between the ages of 15 and 16, and I'm incredibly proud of it, and I've got copies for sale over here, or if you don't want to give me any money, it's also available on all major streaming platforms. So I'd like to play a song from the album, if y'all are cool with it. So this is the last song in the album, and it's called I'm on Fire, But I'm Fine. I didn't believe Bo Burnham when he said my phone helps me dissociate and it give me a disorder when I'm alone. But now I'm sitting in the Starbucks line and I'm realizing I've spent my life as an NPC in someone else's world. Someone told me when I was 14 there was a chance I might have ADHD, and I didn't believe them because I was young and naive. But now I'm 21, and now that I'm a full adult, my disorder is now my personality. I was smart, and I took their words and I brought them all to heart. I never wanted to let them down, you see, so I lowered the bar so gently, and now I'm a store-bought man with ADHD. And yes, I'm still on that, it's my only personality. I'm having a breakdown, and it's the best one of my life. What if I write something wrong? Will people still think of me as a well-rounded guy? I think that it's worth a try if I could ever make up my mind. I liked it better when I didn't have to think or breathe or remember that I was alive. I'm having a breakdown, and it's the best one of my life. Trying to make everything right. Spiral straightened down, so I throw up my hands and I enjoy the ride. Believe me when I say that I'm on fire. I'm having a breakdown, and it's the best one of my life. What's the point of trying to make everything right? Spiral straightened down, so I throw up my hands and I enjoy the ride. Incredibly proud of that song, and it's a song that almost didn't happen, so yeah, and that was my first time ever doing it live, so I'm very excited. So I just moved back into college this week, and I think this song is very fitting, so this is a song called High School Never Ends. The whole damn world is just as obsessed with who's the best dressed and who's having sex. Who's got the money, who gets the honeys, who's kinda cute and who's just a mess. And you still don't have the right look, and you don't have the right friends. Nothing changes but the faces. doesn't matter if you're 16 or 35. Reese Witherspoon, she's the prom queen. Bill Gates is captain of the chess team. Jack Black's the clown. Brad Pitt's the quarterback. Seen it all before. I want my money back. The whole damn world is just as obsessed with who's the best dressed and who's having sex. Who's in the club and who's on the drugs. Who's throwing up before they digest. And you still don't have the right look. And you don't have the right friend. And you still listen to the same shit you did back then. High school never ends. Indiana in August. God. So another shameless plug, I just put out an album on Monday, and it's available everywhere, including here, and this is another song from the album. Sorry. this is a song called The Promise. This is your fault, okay? I promised back in 2019 I'd save this drink for you. So much to do. You and I, we were so young, it felt the dumbest promise I made since 2019. I never got to fill that void. Frankly, I'm not crying. I promise that against my will, and I applaud you for trying. Myself, and I kept it out of spite. I promised you so many things, but this one I can keep. Together, I don't wanna be fine. I wanna be obsessed. I wanna feel too much. I wanna be a mess. I don't wanna be good. I wanna be the best. Wanna be over the moon the way that I am with you. And you wrap me up and kiss me so and say my name. Now that I know what better is like, I don't wanna be fine. I don't wanna be fine. This theme, I'm very much enjoying it, and I couldn't do a Broadway con without doing this song. This is a song called Skipper Dan, and it's by Weird Al. Starting every high school play, through every drama teacher way, I graduated first in my class at Juilliard. While I read my Uta Hagen and studied the bar. like they've done for the last 50 years. Now I'm laughing at my own jokes, but I'm crying inside, cause I'm working on the joke. One of the absolute most talented musicians in the fandom is going to be joining me for a couple of songs. I'm going to let him do a couple songs himself. So with me on stage, I'd like to welcome Citrine Husky.
Well, since my friend here was plugging their album, I'll go ahead and plug mine. So I'm getting ready to release my 12th album, but I'm a gray muzzle, so I deserve what I get. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and do one of the songs that I wrote about 2 years ago. Right before the pandemic, I was at a convention, and I was on a flight, and basically the kid in front of us was telling his mom, you know, he's got no sight, and pointing at my cane, and the mom was trying to shush the kid, and so long story short, the kid made a point that I really liked. He said that we could all see the same because he couldn't see the ground either. So I ran with that. This song became the title of my 5th album. It's called In Plain Sight. I hope you like it. Arrived at the airport, went through TSA, got to the terminal, I sat and waited. When they called my flight, I got on the plane. Everything's going great. I felt the engine start as we took off. Felt the ground leave us as we went along. And almost immediately I was in shock, cause I had a thought we were all in plain sight. At 30,000 feet we were all right. We could all see the same even though it was daylight. And if only for a minute they could see the world through my. Said, would you like something to drink? Said, yeah, I'll take a Coke, please. Or really anything. Cause I had a smile upon my face. Joy inside I couldn't erase. Cause I was so damn amazed that we were all the same. We were in plain sight. At 30,000 feet we were all alive. We could all see the same even though it was.
inside. 30,000 feet, we were all alive. Could all see the same even though it was daylight. And if only for a minute they could see the world through my eyes. We were all in plain sight. So book another flight, another flight tonight. Just take
Broadway con without doing a Broadway song, because fun fact about me, I thought I was going like into musical theater until my senior year of high school, so I'm actually trained to do musical theater. And so I wanted to do a song from one of my favorite musicals, from Dear Evan Hansen, and this is a song called For Forever, accompanied by the wonderful Citrine Husky. Okay, so you're just doing harmony and end of May or early June, this picture-perfect afternoon we share. Drive the winding country road, grab a scoop at Hollow Boat, and then we're there. An open field that's framed with trees, we pick a spot and shoot the breeze like buddies do. Quoting songs by our favorite bands, telling jokes no one understands except us two. And we talk and take in the view. All we see is sky for forever. We let the world pass by for forever. Feels like we could go on for forever this way. Two friends on a perfect day. We walk a while and talk about the things we'll do when we get out of school. Bike the Appalachian Trail, or write a book, or learn to sail. Would that be cool? There's nothing that we can't discuss, like girls we wish would notice us, but never do. He looks around and says to me, there's nowhere else I'd rather be, and I say, me too. And we talk and take in the view. We just talk and until the entire sun shines on my
give way. I'm on the ground, my arm goes numb. I look around, and I see he's come to get me. He's come to get me, and everything's okay. All we see is sky for forever. We let the world pass by for forever. Buddy, you and I for forever this way. On a perfect
super soaker filled with pee. Because the big screen's calling, final casting call. It's your big shot, baby. You're the next big star of another stupid movie about a guy with a broken heart who's falling apart. I'm headed for the cutting room floor, and in the sequel, honey, I'm the guy who gets the girl. All apologies to Kevin Costner and that chick from Monsters. And even Val Kilmer, he was funny and real genius. Top Secret was funny too, but he sucked as that man. Final casting call, it's your big shot, baby. You're the next big star of another dumb movie about a guy with a broken heart who's falling apart. Steven Spielberg's calling and he's setting a car. It's your shot, baby, you're the next big star of another stupid movie about a guy with a broken heart who's falling apart. I'm headed for the cutting room floor, and in the sequel, honey, I'm the guy that gets the girl. Gets the girl. I'm the guy that gets the girl. Gets the girl. I'm the guy that gets the girl.
When I'm feeling lonely,
as I can be. All by myself on an uncharted island in an endless sea. What makes me happy? Fills me up with glee. Those bones in my jaw that don't have a flaw. My shiny teeth and me. My shiny teeth that twinkle just like a sergeant's face. My shiny teeth that sparkle. Smile, shiny teeth and me. Yes, they're all so perfect, so white and pearly. Brush, garb, or rinse, a couple breath mints. My shiny teeth and me. Shiny teeth so awesome, just like your favorite song. My shiny teeth are blossom, so they grow to be real strong. Shiny teeth and me. Musicians, and I just want to point that out. What are you feeling?
Well, you can see the time better than I can, so I don't want to overtake the time.
It is 4:41.
Okay.
Well, we're going to actually do one of Citrine's songs, because Citrine writes music as well. I'm not the only one who can advertise for themselves, too. Citrine, you want to plug something?
Sure. So I have a concert tonight, 9:30 to 10:30. Might be in Indianapolis B, unless it gets fire coded, then it'll be moved somewhere else. But we'll see how that works. So as I said, I've got 12 albums. The 12th one's on the way at this point. But like I told them, while you're taking a break for a second, I'm a great muscle, so it works. So I get my comeuppance. I don't know it.
Oh, okay. Oh. Yeah, so this is one of his songs that the first time I heard it made me sob uncontrollably, and this is a song called Forever.
This one was written 5 years ago right here at IFC out there in the atrium. Somebody was walking by and they said they were getting ready to leave. And with tears in their eyes, they said, if I could stay here forever, that'd be all right with me. And that's where this came from. Got here on a Thursday, and I checked in. Can't wait to hang out with all my friends. But now that I'm here, I'm finally thinking. If it were up to me, I'd never check out again. Cause if I could stay here forever, that'd be alright with me. And I'd check out the day after never, cause that day never will be. Some say, live and let live. Some say one day you'll forget, but oh no, not this, cause this is what heaven is, here with all my friends.
alright. And then I check out the day after never, 'cause that day never will be. And if I could stay here forever, that'd be alright with me. Then I should have seen the day after never, 'cause that day
is at my show tonight, like I said, 9:30 to 10:30 in NDB. I'm going to do a song from my second album. I wrote this one. It holds a lot more weight nowadays because of the pandemic and everything that's happened over the past couple years. But the phrase, here's to you, here's to me, forever friends will be the Chicago toast. I took that, interpreted it ever so slightly. And this song was originally written, if you've ever got a chance to meet them, they're an amazing person. It was originally written for Dog Bomb, and also simultaneously was written for Twidget. So this is called Rest in Peace.
A party, he'd be the last shot, the one that meant the most, the Chicago toast. He'd be the last one to leave, but the first one there to drive you home. Memories like alcohol that burns as I grieve. Can't believe you're not here with me. So here's to you, here's to me. Forever friends will always be. I'll hold on to your memory. Oh, cheers to you. Rest in peace. Always the first one to lend a hand. Never said I cared, but I can. The last one to judge you or laugh, but the first one there if you need a friend. Tragedy like shattered glass cuts as my soul bleeds. Remembering what's so dear to me. Singing here's to you, here's to me. Forever friends will always be. I'll hold on to your memory. So cheers to you. Rest in peace. will always be. Thank you for the memory. So cheers to you. Rest in peace. Oh, cheers to you, my friend. Rest.
Shirts, I've got CDs, I can show you where to order the vinyls, but those are gone at the moment, and I can show you where to check out more of my music and Citrine. You have a concert in Indie B at 9:30, and you'll have CDs there.
Please come and create IFC's fire code.
Yeah!
I'll have my albums there, a portion of my proceeds this weekend. Do go to the charity, so do feel free, and also in the charity auction, I forgot to mention this, I'm taking this over to Conops like right after this.
Yep.
but I am putting in the charity auction. You can get one of each of my albums as a collection, and if it goes for over $100, there's a custom song commission with that. But that's for the charity auction. So yay for the charity!
I should probably promote that too. So when I released the album, I did an Indiegogo that raised $800 for the production of it. And the top tier came with a shirt, an album, and a custom song that comes on the extended version. So the highest bidder in that will also get that full lot. So what we're saying is, if you want furry music, come to the charity auction and pay a lot of money for it. I've been ending my sets with this song for as long as I can remember, and it's another Weird Al song, and I really hope you like it. And sincerely, thank you so much for being here. This is called Yoda. Swamp down in Dagobah, where it bubbles all the time like a giant carbonated soda. S-O-D-A soda. Saw the little Ron sitting there on a log. I asked him his name, and in a raspy voice he said, Y-O-D-A Yoda. Yo, yo, yo. If you start to go astray, let the force be your guide. Oh my Yoda, yo 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 Yoda. I know Darth Vader's really got you annoyed, but remember, if you kill him, then you'll be unemployed. Oh my Yoda, yo 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 Yoda. Well, I heard my friends really got in a mess, so I'm gonna have to leave Yoda, I guess. But I know that I'll be coming back someday. I'll be playing this. Long term.